Are you wondering how to send your transcript to WIS and ensure that they accept the transcript for your ECA evaluation?
Then wonder no more, because this video will cover how your transcript should be sent to WIS, covering the most common scenarios, the obstacles that people face, and how to tackle them.
Hi, and welcome to Choose Canada. This is Roshan
and Lalita,
and we are here to help you immigrate and live in Canada.
We upload videos on immigrating to Canada and scoring high in IELTS almost every week. So if you are new here and interested in our content, make sure you press that subscribe button and also the bell icon so that you stay up to date with our latest videos.
Getting your Education Credential Assessment, or ECA for short, is one of the first and most crucial steps in determining your eligibility to immigrating to Canada. Your ECA report determines what your education outside of Canada is worth within Canada. Both your eligibility score and your CRS depends on the ECA you have, and it holds a validity of 5 years.
And World Education Services, or WES, is one of the most preferred institutes for getting the ECA report. This is because they are the fastest among the institutes that offer to provide your ECA report, and you might already know how time is a very crucial factor in determining when you will get your ITA.
Transcripts are one of the required documents in all of these ECA providing institutes. Now, a lot of people make some common and avoidable mistakes while sending their transcript, which can lead to them rejecting your document and expect you to send your document again.
This obviously would lead to waste of time, money, effort, and worst of all, you might not be able to participate in few CRS draws just because you made a mistake and do not have your ECA report sooner. Also note that this video does not apply for sending your degree. You will need to upload the degree directly to your profile. It is also important for you to check the official link to learn what are the required documents that needs to be arranged and how to send them to WIS. Even though this video covers the common scenarios for most of the applicants, it is a good idea to check the website as well.
So pay attention to the instructions in this video. We'll be going through the 3-step process to send your transcript to WIS. And make sure you stick till the very end, because as a bonus, we will also be sharing when you might want to consider using institutes other than WIS for getting your ECA.
Step 1 of the process involves applying for transcript from a university. The procedure for applying will vary with each university, so visit your university website and you will definitely be able to find to the procedure for applying for transcripts.
Now you need to understand that transcripts are nothing but your mark sheets which are attested by your university. So your university might have given details about getting attestation for your university documents rather than calling it transcripts. But be assured that they are the same as transcripts and very much accepted by WIS.
Yes, some universities would print a new transcript, while others would just sign the mark sheet copies that you take with you. WIS accepts both of these. Apart from that, if your university charges you a hefty fee for each signature, you can take your consolidated mark sheet and get only that document signed.
Also, some universities charge fees to sign the WIS request form. Remember that the WIS request form is optional and not sending it will not affect the process. So if you want to save some money, make sure to apply only for transcript and nothing else. So once you're done applying, we'll move on to step 2.
Step 2 involves sending the documents that are requested by the university. Now these documents are generally your university degree and your mark sheet. Some universities would want to verify and ask for the original documents, while others are okay with just photocopies of it. For more specific details, you can visit your university website.
There are cases where the university or institute would allow you to apply for transcripts online, make payment, upload the documents, enter WIS's address, and the university will directly send your transcript to WIS.
There are also other cases where you can apply for transcripts by sending a letter, copies of your documents, and demand draft that includes payment for transcript and courier charges to WIS. And the university will send your transcript on your behalf.
But in general, you might be required to go in person with the required documents and apply for transcripts to be sent to WIS. You might also need to carry an envelope that can be used to send the transcript. Before going, try to call your university and get the available timings and other details for you to visit.
In case you are not living in the same city as your university, most universities will allow a person authorized by you to submit documents, apply on your behalf, and later, if needed, pick the transcripts. All this process needs is an authorization letter signed by you.
Once you have applied for transcripts, your university might take some time to issue the transcript. If it's just attestation, it will take them around 3 to 5 days. If it's a newly printed transcript, it would take them from 1 to 3 weeks.
Before we go to the next step, if you're enjoying this video and finding this video useful, make sure you hit that like button. This will help this video with the YouTube algorithm and reach out to many more people who are in need of these instructions. Hope you have hit that like button. Let's move on to step 3.
Step 3 involves sending your transcripts to us. Now this is the most crucial step of all, and this needs some planning ahead. In many countries, including India, WES does not accept the transcript if you send them on your own. We have left a link in the description that directs you to the website where you can check the required documents and how they need to be sent to WES. Make sure to check what is accepted for your country.
If WES accepts the transcript sent by you for your country, well and good. You can send the transcript to WES by yourself. We will be going over what you need to make sure before sending your transcript to WES soon. But if not, WES expects your university to send your transcript, not you. So, when you are applying for the transcript, you need to ask your university if there is an option where they will be sending your transcripts on your behalf.
If your university has that option, go for it. Ask your university to send your transcript on your behalf. You might need to pay for the courier charge as well, so plan accordingly.
However, not all universities has that facility. If your university does not send your transcript to WES directly, don't worry, because there is a way out that can avoid transcript rejection. And we will be going over that process. So listen carefully to what we are about to say.
Collect your transcript and the envelope that you submitted from the university. Make sure your university has signed or stamped across the flap of the envelope. This is applicable regardless of which country you belong to. This is mandatory.
After that, you can fill the two addresses as the WES address, which is shown on the screen. Make sure you enter your WES reference number as the first line. This will be used by the WES employees to map the transcript to your application.
Now, for people who are allowed to send the transcript on their own, you can send this package to any post office or courier service without a second thought. For others who need the university to send the transcript, but the university do not offer to send directly to WES, they need to fill the firm address as the address of the university.
Make sure your name is not part of the firm address, as it might lead to your document getting rejected. Now, many universities will have post office or courier office within their own premises. Make sure you send the package from that office.
If in case your university does not have a post office like that, send from a post office or courier office that has the same PIN code as your university.
If you follow the instruction that we laid out, there is a high chance that WES will consider the package to be sent directly from your university and your document will not get rejected.
With that, we have come to the end of the process. Now for the bonus. Although I did mention that WES is the fastest institute to generate your ECA, there are some exceptional scenarios where you need to consider going with other ECA institutes that are appearing on the screen.
WES does not give master's equivalency for few Indian degrees like MBA. Rather, WES will be evaluating your education as a degree plus diploma, and you might lose 7 precious points from your CRS. Please note that WES does give master's equivalency to degrees such as M.Tech or ME. So, if you have completed master's in engineering or technology, you can definitely go with WES.
If you're not sure what evaluation WES would give you, WES provides a tool to calculate your potential evaluation in their website. You can check that out before registering with WES.
We have given the link for the tool in the description box below. If you are not getting the expected result from WES, research and apply for ECA from any of these other institutes appearing on the screen.
Thank you for watching this video. We hope you found it helpful and informative.
If you have any doubts or need any clarifications, make sure you comment below. We will be reading all your comments and will try to respond to any of your questions.
Meanwhile, if you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content.
We will meet you on our next video. Till then, have a great day and all the best on your journey to Canada.